I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real.
Okay, section 4.2, we're starting logarithms. So we're going to take it slow here. We're going to do this over 2 days because this can get overwhelming fast. But if you stay up to date, we can do this, okay? So question for you. What's the inverse of y equals b to the x power? So first of all, y equals b to the x, you should recognize from last day, this is the exponential function. And if you recall, we saw what the graph of that looked like in the last video. And I'm asking, what's the inverse of this? Well, to get inverse, remember what you do? You change f of x to y, but we don't have f of x in this case, so we'll skip that step. Then we replace y with x and x with y, so this y becomes x, and this x here becomes y. Good, and then the next step is that we solve for y. We want to get the y by itself. So go ahead, solve for y, isolate y, get it by itself. I hope you're saying to yourself, I have no idea how to do that. We've never taught you that. So we have a problem here. We can't solve for y, right? If it was 3y equals x, you know how to get the y by itself. You divide by 3. You do the opposite operation. So the opposite operation of multiplying is to divide. If it was y divided by 3 equals x, the opposite operation to get the y by itself would be to multiply. If it was y plus 3 equals x, you do the opposite operation, you'd subtract 3. If it was y minus 3, you do the opposite operation, you'd add 3. But what's the opposite operation of an exponent? We don't have that. Not yet. Here it comes. The opposite operation of an exponent is a logarithm. A logarithm reverses the operation of exponentiation. And what exponentiation is when you raise a number to a power. Should we write that down? Exponentiation is raising a number to a power. And a logarithm reverses that operation. Basically, a logarithmic function asks, how many of one number, the base, do we multiply to get another number, the argument? And I haven't told you what the argument is yet, so I'll just put all this in down here and then I'll show you what I mean. And also, a logarithmic function is an exponent. A logarithmic function is actually an exponent. It's the exponent to which one value, the base, must be raised to produce some amount, the argument. Okay, so here's how it looks. Y equals log subscript of b there, little b, x, is another way to write what we wrote up top, x equals b to the y power. These two things are equivalent to each other, okay? X equals b to the y power, that's a y there, is equivalent to y equals log bx, and I'll explain what this all means in a second here. Okay, so first of all, let's name these things. What's this y called over here? This is the exponent. Well, believe it or not, what we usually say makes an exponent an exponent is that it's the little number written up top. Not always, because this is the exponent right here. I know that's strange, but that's the exponent. And that's what we're trying to find when we're solving a question like this. We're trying to find what is the exponent. The b here, what do we call that? That's the base. So this b here, whoops, I missed. That's terrible. That b points, that arrow points to the base, and it's also pointing here. This is also the base. And that leaves us with one other thing, and that is this x right here. And this x, whoop, that x is the argument. So let's take a look at these two explanations here again. This statement right here, y equals log b x, asks how many of one number, so how many b's, do we multiply to get another number, the argument, and the argument is x. So for example, if we had log 2 16, and I wanted to know what that equals, what I'd be asking is, how many of the little number here, the base, how many of those bases do we have to multiply to get 16? You go 2 times 2 times 2 times, how many of them? 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16. Hey, there we go. So the answer is 4. The answer of log 2 to 16 means how many 2's do we multiply to get 16? We multiply 2 4 times. In other words, 2 to the 4th power is 16. See what we did? We found the exponent. Another way to think of it is, it's the exponent to which one value, the base, in this case 2, or b here, must be raised to produce some amount, the argument. So what do we have to raise 2 to get 16? 2 to the what equals 16? That's not a zero, that's like a space. What goes in there? 2 to the what equals 16? Oh, it's 4. So the answer is 4. Okay, I know I'm taking it painfully slow, but I really want to make sure you get a sense of this. If you never grasp exactly what you're solving with logarithms, it just becomes so abstract that you have no idea what you're even doing. You're like doing all this work with logarithms, and you're like, I have no idea what this even means, but I'll keep trying. So it makes it easier if you understand what you're talking about. Logarithms are very important. There's all sorts of practical applications to them. They can be, should I write this down? Why not? They are used... So logarithms are used in pH, the pH scale, you know, of acidity and alkalinity, base and acid. That's a logarithmic scale. Same with the Richter scale. You know what that's used for, right? Earthquakes. That's a logarithmic scale. Decibels, how loud things are. That is a logarithmic scale. All sorts of places use logarithms. And they're used a lot in math, and they're used a lot in calculus, and which is part of math. So, okay, so how do we say this log 2 8? You don't actually say log 2 8. You can say, whoops, you can say the logarithm to base 2 of 8. I find that almost no one says that. You could say the logarithm of 8 to base 2. Yes, more people say that. I would say the most common way people say it is the base 2 log of 8. That's probably the most common way to say it. And what I'll try to not say, even though when you're working with tons of these things, you kind of resort to this sometimes, is log 2 of 8. It's really not that accurate to say it that way, so I'll try not to say it that way, but if I do, you'll know what I'm talking about. I'll try to always say it this way, the base 2 log of 8. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to convert from logarithmic form to exponential form. I said that this form here, yeah, let's not use that color, let's use this color. This form here is the same as this form there. This is the logarithmic form, this is the exponential form. We're going to switch from one to the other. So how do we do that? We remember our explanation. What a logarithm is asking us is, how many times do I raise the base, believe it or not, that's the base, this is the base here. The base is raised to what exponent, that's our answer, the exponent, to get this argument. Is this true? Is 5 to the 4th power 625? Yes, it is. I'm not asking you to solve anything here. All I'm asking you is to rewrite it. Okay, so these better be true because I wrote them all. And they are true because I wrote them right. So how would we write this one? Think of it, this little number here, we call it the base in both cases. So it must become the base of our exponent. That 4 becomes the base. Remember that a logarithm is an exponent, so the answer you get is an exponent, so that must go there, and the argument is the answer, if you want. Is this true that 4 to the negative 1 is 1 quarter? Yeah, that's a flip a negative, flip it over, and you get 1 fourth. Hey, it looks like something's missing there. What's not there? There is no base there. What's going on? Well, we have something called a common logarithm. And if you really understand what I'm talking about right now, you should be able to figure out what number would go here to make sense. Come on, someone, get it so I think that I know that at least one person understands this. A common logarithm is a logarithm to base, figure out what it is, base 10. Why base 10? Because so much of our number system is based on 10, right? Think of it, we count ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, those are all multiples of 10. So this is the reason we use base 10 as our common logarithm. This happens a lot in math, right? If I just put this and there's no number out front here, what number do we know for sure is there? A 2. If I put 3x and I put no number as an exponent, what number is there? A 1. If I just put m and there's no number in front, what number is there? A 1. And here's another one of those cases. If I put a logarithm and I put no number as its base, the base is 10. So you have to get used to the idea that log 10 of some number, I'll call it x, is exactly the same as just saying log x. If you don't see a number there, a base, it means 10. All right, all that, let's get back to the question. That means we have a base of 10, our exponent is 2, and the argument is 100, and that's true, 10 squared is 100. Okay, now we're going to go back the other way. I find this a little bit more difficult, so let's think about it. We're going to put log, the little number is the base, so that's 4. And remember, what we're going to end up with is an answer, which is the exponent, so that must go there, and this must go there. Yeah, that's right, 4 cubed is 64, yep. Okay, next one. Our base is 2, so that's the small number down here is the base. Then we put our argument, which is 1/8. And it equals the exponent. What do we have to raise 2 to? What exponent do we raise 2 to get 1/8? We're saying that you raise 2 to negative 3 to get 1/8. Is that true? Yeah, it's true. 2 to the negative 3, it's a flipping negative, right? 2 to the negative 3 is the same as 1 over 2 cubed, and that's 1 over 8. Yeah, that's right. You have to raise 2 to the negative third power to get 1/8. Okay, one more. Log. What is our base? The base is 100. The argument is 10. And you should always be left with the exponent over here is 1/2. Is 100 to the 1/2 10? Yep, 1/2 means, what's 100 to the 1/2 mean? It's the same as the square root of 100, right? That's what 1/2 exponent to the 1/2 is, and that definitely equals 10, so that's right too. Okay, evaluate the following without a calculator. So the base 3 log of 81, the base 3 log, so the base is 3, and we're asking what power, what exponent do we have to raise that 3 to? So we don't know what exponent, let's put x. What exponent do we raise that to get an answer or an argument of 81. How are we going to solve that? Hey, I know, we can do exactly what we did last day. Let's try to get the same base here. Let's leave this as 3 to the x and turn this into 3 to the, what's 81 equal? It's 3 to the 4th. Now we have the same base, we can equate the exponents, we have our answer, x equals 4. Alright, what number is that? I can't even read that. That is log 6, right? So this is, sorry, log, the base 6 log of 1. So the base is 6. We're asking what power or what exponent do we have to raise it to get an answer or an argument of 1. That's a strange one. What do you raise 6 to get 1? Anything to the 0 power equals 1. Next, this is the common logarithm. In other words, it's a base 10 log, so 10 to the x equals 0.001. 10 to the x equals, if you don't know how to do that, this is the same as 1 over tenths, hundred thousandths, 1 over a thousand, which is the same as 10 to the negative 3. You probably didn't need to do that middle step, but in case you did, there you go. They have the same base, so now you know that x equals negative 3. Okay, a few more difficult ones at the bottom here. The base 2 log of root 8. Okay, so 2 to the x power, because 2 raised to some power that we don't know, some exponent that we don't know, is equal to root 8. Okay, let's try to get the bases the same. We'll leave this as 2. This is the same as the square root of 2. 2 to the what equals 8? 2 cubed. Still not great because we have that square root sign, but remember, that's the same as 2 cubed all to the square root's the same as to the 1/2. Okay, we got the same base now. X equals, this is a power of a power, 3 times 1/2 equals 3/2. Finished. Okay, the base 25 log of 5. Base is 25 raised to the some power or exponent that we don't know what it is yet. We have to get an answer of 5. Okay, let's try to get the same base. Let's make it 5 this time. 25 is the same as 5 squared raised to the x power equals 5. We've got the same base now. This is a power of a power. 2 times x is 2x equals 5 to the, what power was here? What exponent? 1, right? 5 to the first power equals 5. So we end up, divide by 2, you end up with x equals 1 over 2 or 1/2. Just divide by 2, divide by 2. Last one. Well, what is that? That is log the square root of 5. So the square root of 5 log of 125. Wow. Base square root of 5. So the base is the square root of 5. We're raising it to some power, x. And we want that to equal 125. We want to get the same base on both sides. Let's make it 5. So the square root of 5 means 5 to the 1/2. X equals 5 cubed. 5 cubed is 125. Now we have the same base on both sides. So power of a power, 1/2 times x is 1/2 x, or x over 2 equals 3. This is divided by 2, so we do the opposite operation. We multiply by 2, we get x equals 6. And we're finished. All right, I really want you to try to get this idea here, which has now disappeared. These two explanations here, if there's one of those that you can get into your head so you're clear what the logarithm function is asking or what it refers to, that'll make a big difference. All right, happy introduction to logarithms, everyone.
What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all.